Hello dear students, in this class we are going to solve exercise 8.1 related to trigonometric ratios. Let us take the first problem. In triangle ABC, right angled at B, AB is equal to 24 cm, BC is equal to 7 cm, determine sin A, cos A, sin C, cos C. We have studied how to solve this type of problems in the previous classes. First, let us draw a right angle triangle A, B, C, and AB is equal to 24 cm, it is given, and BC is 7 cm. First, we need to find all the three sides. Since two sides are given, the third side you can find using Pythagoras theorem. So let us use Pythagoras theorem and find the third side using Pythagoras theorem. What we get? Hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. So AC square is equal to AB is 24. So 24 square plus 7 square. How much is 24 square? 24 square is 576. 576 plus 7 square is 64. So if you add 576 and 64, you will get it as 625. So AC is equal to square root of 625 is 25 centimeter. Once you know all the three sides of a right angle triangle, you can find any trigonometric ratio. Along with this, you must remember this. Old horse, always remember his owner's approach. You know this is for sine theta, this is for cos, and this is for tan. Now, let us take the first problem. Sine A. What is sine A? With respect to this angle A, with respect to angle A, BC is the opposite side. AB is the adjacent side and AC is the hypotenuse. Right. So sine is opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite side is BC and hypotenuse is AC. So BC is 7, AC is 25. Similarly, you can find cos A. Cos A is adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent side is AB. Hypotenuse is AC. How much is AB? AB is 24 by 25. Similarly, we can find the value of sin C and cos C. But now, you must find sin C and cos C with respect to this angle C. So, with respect to this angle C, AB will become the opposite side and BC will become the adjacent side. AC will remain same, that is the hypotenuse. So sin C is opposite by hypotenuse. With respect to C, AB is opposite side. So AB by AC. AB by AC. AB is 24 cm, AC is 24 cm. And AC is 25 cm. Similarly, cos C. With respect to C, this is the opposite side, this is the adjacent side. So cos is adjacent by hypotenuse. So BC by AC. BC is 7, AC is 25. So a very simple and easy problem. Hope you understood. Okay. Next, let us move on to the second problem. In the figure, find tan P minus cot R. And they are given the figure. If you want to find the value of any trigonometric ratios, a right angle triangle, first we must draw a right angle triangle and we must find all the three sides of the right angle triangle. And knowing the three sides of a right angle triangle, we can find the value of any trigonometric ratio. So first let us find the third side of this right angle triangle. how you will find the third side using Pythagoras theorem. Yes, using Pythagoras theorem we can write, using Pythagoras theorem we can write QR square is equal to hypotenuse square minus PQ square. So QR square is equal to PR square is 13 square minus PQ square is 12 square. This is equal to 13 square is 169, 12 square is 144. So QR square is equal to 169 minus 144 is 25. So QR is square root of 25, that is 5. So we got the third side. Once you know all the three sides of a right angle triangle, you can find the value of any trigonometric ratio. First let us find tan P, then cot R, then we will subtract. First let us take tan P. See, with respect to this angle P, with respect to angle P, QR is the opposite side, PQ is the adjacent side, and PR is hypotenuse. We know tan of any angle is opposite by adjacent side. Here the opposite side is QR by PQ. QR is equal to 5 and PQ is 12. So that is tan P. Similarly, let us find cot R. Now, you must find the value of cot with respect to angle R. So, with respect to this angle R, your PQ will become the opposite side and QR will become the adjacent side. As you know, cot is the reciprocal of tan. Tan is what? Opposite by adjacent. Reciprocal of it is adjacent side by opposite side. So with respect to this angle R, cot R is adjacent by opposite. Which is the adjacent side with respect to R? The adjacent side with respect to angle R is QR. So QR by PQ. QR by PQ. QR is 5 centimeter, PQ is 12 centimeter. So cot R is 5 by 12. Now let us find the value of tan P minus cot R. Tan P is how much? 5 by 12 minus cot R is also 5 by 12. What is 5 by 12 minus 5 by 12? That is 0. Hope you understood. Simple problems. Okay. Next, let us take the third problem. Third problem. If sine A is equal to 3 by 4, calculate cos A and tan A. A very simple and easy problem, as you all know. Okay, let us try to solve this. Let us consider a right angle triangle A, B, C. Now, with respect to angle A, what is sine A? With respect to this angle A, BC is the opposite side, AB is the adjacent side, and AC is the hypotenuse. So opposite by hypotenuse, that is BC by AC. And it is given that sine A is equal to 3 by 4. So from this, you will come to know that BC is 3 units and AC is 4 units. So let us find the third side using Pythagoras theorem. Using Pythagoras theorem, AB square will be equal to AC square minus BC square. AC square is 4 square minus 3 square. So 4 square is 16. 16 minus 3 square is 9. How much is 16 minus 9? 16 minus 9 is 7. So AB is equal to square root of 7. So AB is root 7. Now, you know all the three sides of a right angle triangle. Then you can find cos A and tan A. What is cos A? Cos A is adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent is AB. Hypotenuse is AC. So AB is root 7 and AC is 4. Similarly, what is tan A? Tan A is opposite by adjacent. Opposite side is BC. Adjacent side is AB. So this is equal to 3 by root 7. See, a very simple problem. Okay, hope you understood. Let us move on to the next problem. Okay, fine. Fourth problem. Given 15 cot A is equal to 8, find sin A and secant A. Very similar type of problem. So here, instead of giving cot A is equal to 8 by 15, they have mentioned it as 15 cot A is equal to 8. So if 15 cot A is equal to 8, how you can write cot A? Cot A can be written as 8 by 15. Instead of giving sin A by 3 by 4, the same problem can be written as 4 sin A equal to 3. Then you must write it as sin A is equal to 3 by 4. That is what is done in this problem. Okay. Now, once the value of a trigonometric ratio is given, you know what has to be done. What you will do? First, you will draw a right angle triangle. A, B, C. Okay. Now, since cot A is given, you know this. Old horse, always remember his owner's approach. Sine, cos, tan. And cot is the reciprocal of tan. If tan is opposite by adjacent, then cot is adjacent by opposite. Now, with respect to this angle A, this is the opposite side, this is the adjacent side, and this is the hypotenuse. Now, cot A is equal to what? Cot A is adjacent side by opposite. Adjacent is AB, AB by BC. So, AB by BC, and it is given that cot A is equal to 8 by 15. From this, you will come to know that AB is 8 units, AB is 8 unit, and BC is 15 units. So from this, let us find the third side. So we will find using Pythagoras theorem. See, I have already told in the previous class that if you need to find the hypotenuse, then we can directly write AC square is equal to BC square plus AB square. If hypotenuse is given and if any other side has to be found, then you can directly write the equation for the other side like this. See, here hypotenuse is given, but AB was not given. Then directly you can write the expression for AB as AB square is equal to hypotenuse square minus the side which is given. If you want hypotenuse, then directly we can write AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Okay. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So what is AB? AB is 8. So 8 square plus BC is 15 square. So do you know the square of 8? Yes, it is 64. 15 square is 225. How much is 225 plus 64? It is 289. So AC square is equal to 289. What is the square root of 289? Square root of 289 is 17. At least you must know first 20 square numbers. Okay, then it will be very useful for you to solve all these type of problems. So AC is equal to 17 units. Now you know all the three sides. Can't you find sine and secant A? Sine A is opposite by hypotenuse. With respect to A, this is the opposite side. So BC by hypotenuse is AC. BC is 15 and hypotenuse is 17. Next you need to find sec. Secant A is the reciprocal of cos. If cos is adjacent side by hypotenuse, then its reciprocal will be hypotenuse by adjacent. So secant A is hypotenuse by adjacent side. That is AC by adjacent side is AB. AC is 17, AB is 8. So this is how you will find the value of sin A and secant A. Okay, next, fifth problem. Next problem, given secant theta equal to 13 by 12, calculate all other trigonometric ratios. It's a very tough problem. You don't know how to solve this, right? Of course, it's a very easiest problem because we have solved many problems of this type. First, what we must do? First, we must draw a right angle, triangle A, B, C. And either you take angle A as theta or angle C as theta. Let me call this angle as theta, angle C as theta. Now, secant theta is given. Actually, what is secant theta? Secant theta is the reciprocal of cos theta. Holders always remember is owner's approach. This is for sine, cos, tan. So with respect to this angle theta, this is the opposite side, this is the adjacent side, and this is the hypotenuse. Now secant theta is hypotenuse by adjacent because it's the reciprocal of cos. Hypotenuse is AC. AC by adjacent side is BC. And it is given that secant theta is 13 by 12. So from this you get to know that AC is 13 units and BC is 12 units. So from this you must find the third side. How will you find the third side? Using Pythagoras theorem. Using Pythagoras theorem, we can write AB square. Directly you can write this expression. AB square is equal to AC square minus BC square. So AC square is how much? AC square is 13. So 13 square minus BC square is 12 square. That is 169 minus 144. So AB square is equal to 25. So AB is equal to square root of 25, that is 5 unit. So AB is 5. AB is 5. Now you must find all the trigonometric ratios of this angle theta. Let us take sine theta. Sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite side is AB, hypotenuse is AC. So that is 5 by 13. Next, cos theta, adjacent side by hypotenuse. Or since it is the reciprocal of secant theta, directly we can write it as 12 by 13. Adjacent by hypotenuse is, adjacent is BC, hypotenuse is AC. That is equal to 12 by 13. Next, tan theta. Tan theta is opposite side by adjacent. Opposite side is AB, adjacent side is BC. So that is equal to 5 by 12. Once you know the first three trigonometric ratios, the remaining three can be written. Cosecant theta. Cosecant theta is the reciprocal of sine theta. Reciprocal of sine theta is 13 by psi. Secant theta is already given. Last one is cot theta. Cot theta, that is the reciprocal of tan theta, that is 12/5. Okay, simple problem. Hope you understood. Okay, let us move on to the next problem, the sixth problem. If angle A and angle B are acute angles such that cos A is equal to cos B, then show that angle A equal to angle B. In the last class, we have solved one problem related to this type. Here, they are given cos A is equal to cos B. In that example problem, it was given that sin A is equal to sin Q. So there, A and Q were two acute angles of two different right angle triangles. But here, they have given cos A equal to cos B. That means angle A and angle B are the acute angles of the same right angle triangle. So here you no need to take two right angle triangles. We can take only one right angle triangle ABC, where this angle A and angle B must be acute. Okay, so ABC. Now, what is given? Cos A is equal to cos B. So first let us take cos A. With respect to this angle A, with respect to angle A, BC is the opposite side, AC is the adjacent side, and AB is the hypotenuse. Cos is adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is AC by AB. AC by AB. Next, let us take cos B. With respect to this angle B, with respect to this angle B, your AC will become opposite side and BC will become adjacent side. So then what is cos B? Adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is BC by AB. BC by AB. And it is given that cos A is equal to cos B. Cos A is AC by AB is equal to BC by AB. See, the denominator is same. So if you want, if you cross multiply this, and if the AB comes here, AB will get cancelled. Since the denominator is same, AB will get cancelled. So finally what we get? We get AC is equal to BC. Look at this right angle triangle. In this right angle triangle, this AC is equal to BC. Do you know that in any triangle, if two sides are equal, then the angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Since AC and BC are equal, the angles which are opposite to equal sides, for this side, this angle, for this side, this angle. So these are the angles which are opposite to equal sides. So angle opposite to equal sides are equal. So therefore, since AC is equal to BC, we can say that angle A is equal to angle B. What is the reason? Because angle opposite to equal side are equal. Opposite to equal side are equal. Equal sides are equal. Okay. If it was given cos A is equal to cos Q, then you are supposed to consider two right angle triangle, and you must prove the concept of similar triangles, and then you must conclude that this angle A is equal to angle Q. But this is a very simple problem. It can be done like this. If you want to make it complicated, you can definitely do that. You can take two right angle triangles, where in one of the right angle triangle you can mark it as like X, A, Y, and you can take another right angle triangle and you can mark it as P, B, Q, and prove that they are similar, and finally you can come to a conclusion that angle A equal to angle B. But no need to do that way, because it's a very simple way of solving this problem. Okay. Next, if you want to solve extra problems after solving a set of problems, I will write extra problems on the board. If you want, you can solve those problems, and if you have any doubts or if you want me to correct the problems that you have solved, what you can do is you can just solve the problems and you can take the pic of those problems and you can send to my WhatsApp number along with your name. So I will go through the problems, and if there are any mistakes, I will correct it and I will send it back to you. Okay, you can note down my WhatsApp number if you need. 9483843189. ಓಕೆ, ನೀವು ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ನ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಸಾಕಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಆಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಉಂಟೋ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ವೋ ಹೇಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ನ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ನ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಆ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ಗಳದ್ದು ಪಿಕ್ನ ತೆಗೆದು ನೀವು ನನ್ನ ವಾಟ್ಸಪ್ ನಂಬರ್ಗೆ ಕಳಿಸ್ಬೋದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹೆಸರ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ, ಆಗ ನಾನು ಅದನ್ನ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ವಾಪಸ್ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಓಕೆ? ಫೈನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಡೌನ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ದೆಮ್. ದ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಟೇಕ್ ಡೌನ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್. ಏಕೆಂದರೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಗೆ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನ ನಾವು ಎಕ್ಸಸೈಸಿಂದ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಅದರಿಂದಾಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ನಾನು ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಆ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನೇ ನಾನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದು. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವೆರೈಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ನ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಅದಾದ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಫೈನ್. ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫೈನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟುಡೇಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಟಿಲ್ ದೆನ್, ಟೇಕ್ ಕೇರ್. ಲವ್ ಯು ಆಲ್.